just heard that was Wes Montgomery solo from Days of Wine and Roses from Boss Guitar, that record. Great track, great record. And so we've been talking about that in my website. We've been talking about the arrangement, that Wes uses, and the reharmonization. He sort of reharmonizes a couple of bits. And what else? And the solo, obviously. So today I just wanted to share a little thing, a little kind of snippet that you can use. So what you do is, and this works for a dominant chord, a minor chord, and a major chord. And what you do is you go up a fifth and play a triad. So let's say we've got G minor. Okay, you go up, there's your root note, G. You go up five, and you arrive at a D. So you can play a D minor triad. That sound. Over the G minor. Okay. So he does that where he goes, he plays that line, and that's over G minor, okay? And it's kind of a cool sound. You're getting into the sort of higher bits of the chord. So if you go up the arpeggio here, you go like G, B flat, D. So you're starting on the fifth, F is the seventh, and then A is the ninth. So you're playing in the sort of that kind of extension kind of end of the chord. You know, if you think of the chord like stacked up like donuts, you know, you've got G, B flat, D, F and A. You're playing in this area rather than sort of this zone. Okay, so that's one thing. If you've got like a major chord, let's say E flat major, again you can go up a fifth. So here you arrive at B flat. And you can play a major triad over that chord. Okay, and it gives you a similar kind of effect, but on a major chord. Okay, and there's one other where you can play like a dominant chord. So let's say D7 or something. So say you've got D7, you go up a fifth, and this time you play a minor triad, right? So there's a convenient thing of, if you have a minor chord, you go up a fifth and play a minor triad. If you have a major chord, you go up a fifth and play a major triad. But for here, you just got to remember that if you have a dominant chord, you go up a fifth and you play a minor triad, right? So still an A minor thing, you know, because we're not playing the third. There's the third, that's the major third, and that's the minor third. We're not bothering with that. We're just playing the triad. Okay, so that happens in that solo. There, the chord is E flat, and he plays pretty much a B flat minor triad. Kind of there. So I'm just running through the solo. Here, kind of a different one here, like, so you could look at this chord, it's a C7, right? But you could look at it as a G flat 7, a tritone substitution, which I'm not going to get into today. But if you go up a fifth, D flat minor, okay, that's kind of what he's playing there, this bit. That's like a D flat minor triad there. Over the C. It's getting a bit mathy now, but I'll stop there, right? But just try this. So if you're playing like a blues in E, like say you're playing a rock blues or something, you know, you go up a fifth, play B minor triad. So just like kind of work that into your, if you do play this kind of music where you're kind of, let's say just playing kind of bluesy type stuff, just to kind of creep into that sort of different sound, the jazz kind of thing, for want of a better word. Try that. So you go in, here's the B minor triad. Okay? So you just imagine you're playing. Mix it in with your regular sort of playing. try that. Triads, massively useful. You can do so much with them, you know, like that major triad thing. If you play it as a chord, so say you've got E major, yuck, and you go up a fifth and play a major triad, that's that one. That's a bit like yeah, that Steely Dan track, Green Earrings, or what else, like Panama or something, you know, uses those of those. That's a feature kind of Van Halen's playing, where he'll, sometimes when he's comping, he plays like great little triad things that he does, you know. That sort of stuff. I mean, that's like every Brian May song, right? You've got like a D triad and an A triad. I'm going massively on a tangent now, but like It's Late or something classic like that. Songs ever. Oh my god. Anyway, God bless Cliff Richard. I'll leave you with that. Bye.